Hi everybody, this is the baseball head, the amazing, spectacular, terrific, the great one, the people's champion, your host, Ahad, and welcome back to the baseball head, too. I hope you like this video and subscribe. We're going to talk about just going around the league a little bit in this video. I'm going to start with the Mariners. The Mariners have come from out of nowhere to basically be in first place. Here we go. This is from Fansided, and you know, today the Mariners were beating the Royals 15-2. And the Teoscar Hernandez has gone absolutely crazy. Hit two more home runs. He's doing really well, and he's really helping, along with Julio Rodriguez, the surging Seattle team. MLB rumors: Mariners surge to the top of AL West, coming at historic pace. Now this is a little dated. In the latest game on Friday's MLB schedule, the Seattle Mariners pulled out of an early deficit against the lowly, pathetic, wretched Kansas City Royals to earn a 7-5 victory, giving them 9 wins in their last 10 games. Well, now it's 10 wins in their last 11 games. But that's even more crucial for the AL West standing in relation to the Texas Rangers and the Houston Astros. The Mariners were 7.5 games back of the Rangers in the AL West on August 15th. They played 9 games since then, but after Friday's win over Kansas City, The M's are now tied for the division lead with Texas and sit a game ahead of the Astros. Unbelievable. How rare is that? Per Stats Perform's OptiStats, is the largest divisional deficit erased in 10 games or fewer since the Dodgers in 1982, when they overcame a 7.5 game deficit as well, but did so in 8 games. Wow. That's amazing. It's not hard to figure out why this happened has transpired in Seattle, though. Obviously, the Rangers hitting skid has helped, but after the Mariners were deemed a disappointment in the first half of the season as they sat around 500, they've gotten white hot. Julio Rodriguez has been at the heart of that with a surge into MVP level form, but the entire roster has backed it up. Over the last 7 games, the Mariners as a team are slashing, get this, 340, with a 422 on base percentage, 536 slugging percentage, 48 runs scored over 6 games. The pitching has done their part too, posting a team ERA of 3.67 and a team whip of just 1.31 over that same span. Everyone expects the Mariners to factor heavily into the playoff race coming into the year, so it shouldn't be too much of a surprise that they're doing exactly that. How they've surged the AL West race, though, is certainly worthy of a pause. That's the one thing about baseball that's funny, is you can have a terrible year, and you can come out of nowhere late in the season and basically be where everyone predicted you to be. You know, what's that old line? The cream always rises to the top, and it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what point it does. It always does at some point. The Cubs are stressed out, according to Fansided. If nothing else, Chicago Cubs have been extremely stressful over the past few weeks. Well, things like Marcus Stroman's injury have factored into that. The heated NL wildcard race has been at the heart of it, especially with the Cubs ultimately middling in the light of that, going just 6-4 in their last 10 games. Entering the weekend, Chicago is still holding on to their wildcard spot in the National League, 4 games back of the Brewers in the NL Central. Both the San Francisco Giants and Cincinnati Reds are just 1 game behind them, and the Marlins still skulking and lurking around at 2.5 games back. That has made every decision that manager David Ross has made this season, particularly over this recent stretch, highly scrutinized. And one of the most frustrating things fans have lamented is veteran lefty Drew Smyly continued to hold his spot in the rotation, despite having an 8.33 ERA and 1.56 since the All-Star break. Thankfully, that's coming to an end. On Friday, Megan Montarumura of the Chicago Tribune reported that Smyly, who was initially slated to start on Sunday in Pittsburgh, would instead move to the bullpen. Aww. With a new starter entering the fray who has yet to be announced. For what it's worth, Smyly is handling the move like a veteran, saying you can't have an ego that moves like this when you're struggling. Yeah, you stunk. As for who takes Smiley's spot in the rotation, that has yet to be determined. Fans are hoping for young Jordan Wicks to get his shot. But we could look at a bullpen game or a number of other options. In the end, though, this has felt like the right move for some time and is mercifully now taking shape. Oh, I know one thing. I've been thinking about this. Aside from the Mets, I've been thinking a lot about Drew Smyly, what's been going on there. I've been very upset that he's pitching for the Cubs. Now, as you can tell, there's a little sarcasm. But that's how what you get here at the Baseball Hut, too. And finally in this video, we're going to talk about Shohei Ohtani. Where is he going to land next season? Now, as you know, he's going to be dealing with this injury to his elbow. He's got a UCL tear. I don't know if he's going to get Tommy John surgery. But here's an interesting rumor. I don't see this as happening. This is probably the least likely place that he'll land. According to FanSided, Red Sox, one of the favorites to sign Shohei Ohtani in free agency. Okay. The Shohei Ohtani injury that has left the Angels star with a torn UCL that he will continue to play designated hitter through the season is a brutal blow for all involved. But at the same time, it has made his looming free agency this offseason even more fascinating than it was always going to be. Most notably, it now appears far more teams are involved than there otherwise would have been. One such team who could be more in the mix and crucially, who may have been more in play all along, the Boston Red Sox. New York Post MLB insider John Heyman ranked the favorites to sign Ohtani in free agency this offseason after the Dodgers, Padres, Angels gave the Red Sox the fourth best odds to sign the two-way superstar this offseason. He noted that Boston and Chaim Bloom have the means to make up for losing Mookie Betts, and more importantly, that Ohtani's preference to stay on the West Coast has been overstated. Bloom's operation on the Red Sox has been under heavy criticism after losing stars like Betts and Xander Bogaerts in recent years, though the team was able to lock up star third baseman Rafael Devers this past offseason. But the club has also long developed a keen relationship with Japanese stars from Daisuke Matsuzaka previously and Masataka Yoshida in this year's free agent class. That could work in their favor with Ohtani. Obviously, the uncertainty surrounding the UCL injury for Ohtani does bring about some concern when it comes to the likely AL MVP. At the same time, though, he remains a generational and all-time level talent who could be an all-star playing just one way. The Red Sox need that type of splash to go over the hump. And while they aren't the leaders, according to Heyman's intel, they could very well have a real shot at making that splash. I am skeptical. Okay? I am very skeptical. Chaim Bloom has not really shown much of an appetite to sign long-term deals for anybody. He signed Justin Turner to a two-year deal. That's worked out. But other than Devers, he was willing to let his shortstop go, be traded Mookie Betts, and he got nothing for Mookie Betts, by the way. So I don't see this as happening. This is the least likely scenario happening. What does it say in this article? The Dodgers, Padres, and Angels? That's about right. I put the Mets in there just due to the fact that they can outbid everybody. And the fact the Mets have Billy Epler as their general manager. He's the one who signed him in Anaheim. So there is a relationship that he has with the Mets' current general manager. Well, if you want more videos about Shohei Ohtani, you want to subscribe to this channel. I'm going to have all kinds of videos on him this entire offseason when we get to the offseason. And you need to subscribe because I'm going to have everything on him until he signs with a team. So let me know what you think about this video. Of course, please subscribe to the Baseball Hut 2. Thank you, and I'll see you later.